There's 104 days of summer vacation, and school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Like maybe
building a rocket, or fighting a mummy, or climbing up the Eiffel Tower, discovering something that doesn't exist, hey, or giving a monkey a shower. Surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here!
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving our sister insane.
Idiot!
As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Barry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
Welcome back to another segment of CSN.
We got a special one for you this week. We're going to break down the three successful sports seasons between football, volleyball, and cross country, and how that's impacted our school. Let's check it out.
Hello, Cardinal Nation. I'm here with Victoria, a cross country runner, and I'm not sure if many people know, with our football team and our volleyball team going to state, that our cross country team was actually just 1 point away from also making it to state. So I'm here with Victoria, and she's going to answer a few questions about the cross-country team because I feel like some people need to know. So Victoria, how did your season go?
So the beginning of the season was a little more difficult than past seasons, with having brand new coaches who had brand new strategies than anything we were used to. And with everything going on with COVID, there was a lot of uncertainty about whether we would even have a full season. So our first meet was St. Mary's, and that's always been the worst race. And this year it was 90 degrees when we ran, and our runners were just dropping like flies, but we still ended up getting first place. So after the first couple meets, we started to get really close with each other and with our new coaches, Jason and Tina. And we had a couple really good races with really good PRs, really good conditions, you know, a lot of fun. And we had a couple really good, really delicious team meals. And that all led up to MAC. And at MAC, we all ran super well. It was a super fun race, and we ended up getting fourth.
And obviously, you guys had a great season. Even with all those obstacles, I think you guys exceeded a bunch of people's expectations, and you had a great year. And could you tell me a little bit about your postseason then?
So regionals was a lot of fun. Our coach said that he's never felt so relaxed during a meet. He said he had full faith that we were going to move on to districts, and we did for the first time in a couple years. And districts was obviously a lot more stressful, and coach really hyped us up and told us that even though we were ranked ninth, which is better than we've been ranked in years, that we'd actually been running fifth when he compared our previous times compared to the times of other teams. So I think all of us completely believed that we were going to move on to state, but it just didn't happen this year, and we were 1 point away from making it to state.
Like I said, you guys had a heck of a year. I feel like Cardinal Nation should appreciate that with the football and volleyball team success. I think cross country deserves just as much respect. So thanks, Victoria.
Hello, I'm Griffin, this is Sam, and we want to personally thank all of the student body and staff for supporting us, our sports teams this year.
And also, we'd like to thank the people behind the scenes, like Mr. Wells, Mr. Overman, Mr. Schrader, the school board, your guys' work does not go unnoticed, and from the depth of our hearts, we'd both like to
thank you.
Hello, and I'm here with Vivian and Emma, who are two of the seniors on the cross-country team that were one place away from making it to state this year. So, Emma, what is your favorite team bonding memory?
Probably playing brain games while we were running.
Vivian?
When we all jumped in Lily's pool on Wet Wednesday.
That sounds like a ton of fun. What was the funniest memory that you've had from this season?
Watching Coco run from spot to spot during the meets.
Vivian?
Probably when we played kickball and Madison threw the ball at Luke Garman's head, specifically right after we were told not to throw it at their heads.
Next question. What was the worst practice you've had this year?
Anytime coach would say we were running on Kettler's Road.
Vivian?
Literally any track practice ever.
Those don't seem very fun. And what was your best team meal?
Caroline's house when we played games the whole time.
Vivian?
Yeah, Caroline's. The nacho pig was delicious.
And do either of you have any advice for the younger classmen?
Trust the process.
Stay weird.
All right, thank you.
Hi, I'm Josie, and I'm here with Katie and Ellie, two senior members of the volleyball team. What is your guys' favorite team bonding memory?
I would have to say this summer when we went to the pond and Brooklyn body slammed everyone.
I remember that.
My favorite was whenever we went canoeing freshman year. We had the gigantic slip and slide that we were on for like an hour.
What's your guys' funniest practice or in-game moment?
Was that sophomore year when Katie had on biker shorts and high socks and the cameraman guy came and she didn't have an extra pair of spandex to wear, so she was stuck wearing biker shorts and it was funny.
My favorite was sophomore year too, whenever the camera guys were there, we were doing a drill and Madison was running around the court and completely wiped out in the camera roll and face smacked in front of everyone and the camera guy got it on film.
What's your guys' favorite team meal?
I would just have to go with the nacho pig, always a classic at the Tiemann's.
That one's very good.
Yeah, I really like the nacho pig too, and I really like whenever like the small businesses would cater in.
What's your guys' least favorite drill?
Satan's drill.
Ooh.
Yeah, Satan's drill.
And what advice do you have to the younger kids?
Just have fun with it. Don't be too scared going into freshman year. It's not that scary.
Goes fast, just make the most of it, have fun, and talk to everyone.
Thank you.
All right. I'm Hunter, and I'm here with senior football players Mitchell and Zach, and we're going to ask them some questions today. So, Mitchell, what would you say was your favorite team bonding moment?
Always turn up in the locker room after W's.
Zach?
The canoe trip we took freshman year after the 7-on-7.
Nice. What would you guys say was the funniest practice or in-game moment?
Probably when Nick Alig would always talk smack to all of our players during practice.
I'd say Spencer Alig last year when he hit his head and then threw his helmet down on the ground for no reason.
Very, very funny indeed. What would you guys say is your worst practice or drill?
Probably 300s where we run a lap around the field and then do a drill.
I'd say the Angry Bird circuit that we used to do.
What would you say is your best team meal?
Probably when we had nacho pig at the Tiemann place.
Definitely the Chick-fil-A that was catered last year.
Those both sound very good. And advice to younger classmen?
I guess just to play together as a unit.
Keep it up. Go to state next year.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. Congratulations to the volleyball team on winning state runners-up, and congratulations to the football team on winning state.
Tune in next week for more fun on CSN. Go Cardinals!